My name is Arya Das. I'm a product manager in the Azure Machine Learning team. I'm here to talk to you about doing model training on Kubernetes using Azure Machine Learning. So let's go ahead and get started. So we'll talk about performing model training, like you can do TensorFlow jobs, you can do PyTorch jobs on existing Kubernetes clusters. Remember, you always have the choice of using Azure Machine Learning PaaS solution, which is fully managed, wherein you just submit jobs and pay per use. Or if your company has chosen to standardize on Kubernetes and you want a portable infrastructure, you want to be cloud native, then you can bring in your own Kubernetes clusters. You can also use Azure Kubernetes Service, which is a fully managed service from Azure. Or you can bring, like I said, Kubernetes clusters from your on-prem or on any other clouds through Azure Arc. With that, though, you get to manage the lifecycle of the Kubernetes cluster, which means that you make sure it's up and running, and then you kind of make sure it is upgraded and functioning properly. So in this demo specifically, we will talk about attaching existing Kubernetes clusters to Azure Machine Learning Workspace. All AKS clusters or other clusters that you brought in through Arc will be visible in the AML Design Studio, as you will see. Attaching refers to basically kind of installing operators and other add-ons to make it useful for training. And workspace is a concept in Azure Machine Learning where you store all your machine learning artifacts. To attach takes about 8 to 10 minutes. We will deploy a sample TensorFlow training job using the Azure Machine Learning Design Studio, and then we will observe how the training job moves in phases. It goes from queue to running, and then it might fail. Or it might go into completed state, we'll find out. So let's go ahead and do the demo. So here you can see the Azure portal, ms.portal.azure.com. You can see a bunch of Kubernetes clusters that I have in my subscription. Some of them, one of the ones that you see is demo cluster, is the one that we are going to use to deploy a training job. And then there is, you can see that there is the one on top of that, it's got a different logo. It's a cluster that is outside of Azure, and I brought it to Azure through Azure Arc integration. So let's go ahead and go to the Machine Learning Studio. This is ml.azure.com. This is a Machine Learning Designer Studio, and we will go. You can see I got a bunch of computes and runs. So this is one place where I do everything. I can create notebooks and machine learning artifacts. So I go to compute and attach compute, and you can see I already have two clusters that I have attached. Let's go attach a new cluster, and this one is the one that we will use for TensorFlow training. Now if you look at the compute name, we'll give it a compute name now, and then we will go ahead and select a Kubernetes cluster. That's the one at the bottom, is the one that we'll use. It's you will see that it's got one node pool and a single node, and it's got standard NV6, which is a GPU node, and then we're going to attach this cluster now. And now attaching takes about 8 to 10 minutes. It installs all the CRDs and all the pods. You can see it is creating. So let's go ahead, look at the cluster in the command line. So you will notice that there's no CRD installed. There's no pod deployed right yet. We just started. And so now the Azure Machine Learning control plane will try to deploy these CRDs. And you can see that there is the Azure Machine Learning operator that is deployed, then there's the PyTorch, then there's a TensorFlow, and there is an MPI job operator along with others. There's also the Volcano scheduler. And now let's go take a look at the pods. Now, if you look at the pods, you will notice there is a bunch of pods deployed. There's the ML operator, there's the FlexVol, there's an init job, there's the job controller that will manage the training jobs, and then we installed a bunch of Prometheus components. If you go refresh, you will notice that the cluster has gone from queued state to succeeded state, which means that all the components are installed. So now let's go do some training. So now we go, this is various steps that we use in Jupyter Notebook to run steps. So here you see that we have the SDK version 1.0. We will enable diagnostics. We will initialize the workspace that we are going to use for this training, which is the workspace that you see. And then we're going to specify a Kubernetes compute. This is the compute name, demo.tf, you will notice. So we got the compute target set up. And now what we're going to do is move on to the next step, which is creating data set for training. These data sets are all here. You can see, let's set the path. And the following step is pretty much you register the data set to a workspace. So like I said, in the workspace, you keep all the artifacts together. Now we will list to make sure just that we have all the data sets. Now let's create a project directory. This is where we will store our training script and all the additional files that are required for the training. And then we will just go ahead and create an experiment. Let's rename the experiment to TF training. And once we have an experiment training, this will all be tracked in one resource. It's the workspace where you will see all the experiments that we run. Now the next step is to create a TensorFlow estimator. What this estimator does is pretty much allows you to kind of set up where the source directory is, what the target compute is, where you're going to run the training job, the entry script, all the dependencies, whether you're going to use CPU or GPU, and then we're just going to submit that. And once you do this step, you're ready to submit the job and perform the training. Now let's run this cell, and it looks like the training is running. It's all set to run. Let's go to experiment. It's the small experiments logo. If you go, you look, I have a bunch of trainings already done. This is the one that we just submitted, TF training. Let's go inside and see. Looks like there's one run which is in queued state. We refresh after a couple of minutes, it will be in running state. And we can look at the output logs. The output logs are useful to kind of debug any issues. This is the standard out of the training job itself. You can go through the logs to find out if there are any issues. And if you look at the Azure ML log, this is the Azure ML performing the training job on the cluster. Again, useful to look at any issues that might be there. And every step is captured. Now if you refresh again, you will notice that the job has been completed. You can look at all the metadata of the run there. If you do a kubectl jobs, you will notice that the training job is completed. Let's take a look at pods, and you will notice that again the training job is done. It's just the highlighted one. That's the one. So it's completed. It looks like we are all set. So let's go ahead and summarize. So the private preview of this is coming at the end of September. Again, you get to choose your existing Kubernetes infrastructure in the cloud or that is on-prem. You can bring it through Arc to run the machine learning workloads. You can store all your ML artifacts in Azure in a workspace. And then you can choose to stay cloud native, opting in to use Azure functionality, including module monitoring, data drift, and other things. Here are some helpful resources for you to learn more about machine learning and Kubernetes on Azure. Thank you for listening.